Governor Babagana Umarazalam started the month of December with a pledge to relocate the College of Business and Management Studies Kwandaga to its permanent site and resettle Dalwa, Mosua, Komala, Sandia, as well as Masafanari communities displaced by the insurgents. Governor Zalam was speaking at a flag-off for the distribution of agricultural inputs and other empowerment stuff provided by the member representing Mafa, Kwandaga and Dikwa Federal Constituency at the lower chamber of the National Assembly, Engineer Ibrahim Mohammed Abuna. He implored philanthropists across the state to support their people.
The member is also donating same quantum of items to the other two local government areas that are within its constituents. This donation will go a long way in addressing some of the problems that our people are facing. Government of Borno State will continue to provide dividend of democracy to the people of Kwandaga local government as well as to the people of other local government areas of Borno State.
I believe that is the right time for me to come up with this program in order to support you in my humble way, to support your government and our people, especially at the time like this.
Driven by the desire to make life meaningful on sustainable manner to his people, Governor Babagana Umara stopped over at Malari village, about 20 kilometers to Maiduguri along the Bama Road, to assess the ongoing reconstruction of the town destroyed by Boko Haram terrorists, forcing the residents to flee for safety at IDP camps. Also in the month of December, Professor Babagana Umarazalam directed for the allocation of land to the Joint Admission and Matriculation Board, JAMB, for the construction of a computer-based center in Maiduguri, and directed the Borno State Geographic Information Service, BOGES, to issue a certificate of occupancy to the zonal office of the board in the state.
Education is the backbone of any meaningful development. And that is why Borno State, within the 2 years of my administration, constructed 21 mega schools. We rehabilitated about 48 schools. I've also constructed more than 500 classrooms. What matters is not the building only. After the construction, then we decided to examine the quality of our service delivery. At the secondary level, we recruited about 1,000 science teachers. We are gradually addressing the root causes of the problem. And therefore, I want to use this opportunity now to direct the Minister of Education, Higher Education, to announce scholarship for indigenous that are willing to study outside Borno.
Most of the didactic structures put up by your administration are educational institutions. The achievements of your government, despite the challenges posed by decade-long insurgency, have been widely applauded and acknowledged both at home and abroad. These achievements are called on people-oriented progress. They are there for all to see and have been largely instrumental to the consolidation of hope and confidence of the people of Borno State.
During the month of December, Governor Babagana Umara was at the Army Hospital in Memalari Barracks to sympathize with the wounded soldiers receiving medical attention after a clash with members of the Islamic State of West Africa province, ISWAP terrorists, at Ran, a border town between Nigeria and Cameroon in Kalabalge local government area. Professor Babagana Umarazalam interacted and consoled with all the affected soldiers and the release of 5 million naira to be shared among all the soldiers on admission, including those unconnected with the Kala Balge battle.
We receive these from His Excellency the Executive Governor for own delivery to the Executive Center.
Also in the month of December, Governor Babagana Umarazulum disbursed over 418 million naira to 79 primary healthcare centers across the state for the smooth takeoff of the Borno State Basic Healthcare Provision Fund under the Borno State Contributory Healthcare Management Agency. The fund is meant for the primary healthcare centers to procure drugs, medical consumables, and managerial needs for the 2022 calendar year.
The Borno State Contributory Health Management Agency is one of the key agencies established by this administration aimed at achieving the universal health coverage in the state. The agency has since started its activities of formal and informal sectors through the accreditation of over 177 primary health care centers and enrolled about 40,000 beneficiaries of the scheme across the state. In this development, government have shown strong commitment in meeting the criteria for the state in disbursement of basic health care provision fund to the two gateways, Borno State Contributory Health Management Agency and State Primary Health Care Development Agency, with a total sum of 796,631,001 naira 42 kobo from the federal government. In addition to this, government has approved the allocation of not less than 1% of the state and local government consolidated revenue fund for the SLC to enroll more vulnerable people in the state to access free health care at both primary and secondary health facilities across the state.
Similarly, in the month of December, Governor Zulum was at the 1,000 housing estate and assessed the damage caused by a rocket suspected to have been fired by Boko Haram ISWAP terror groups, with a call on the military to wake up and ensure adequate surveillance, saying for the insurgents to have come so close to fire rockets, something was wrong that needed to be checked. In his quests to inculcate community resilience and self-sufficiency across the state, especially among resettled communities, Governor Babagana Umarazulum in December banned the distribution of food and non-food items to internally displaced persons of resettled communities. This, according to Governor Zulum, is to ensure that the resettled communities have time to settle and start a new life. Professor Babagana Umara thanked and acknowledged the support being obtained from non-governmental organizations to the people and said the state government is deeply committed to supporting his people build resilience and support themselves out of poverty. Governor Zulum added that he will ensure coordination and reduce duplication in new areas that partners may wish to intervene. Also during the month under review, Governor Babagana Umarazulum expressed the readiness of his administration to support the indigents of Borno State to engage in innovative ventures that will improve the socio-economic well-being of the state. Governor Zulum was speaking when he inspected electric buses manufactured in Maiduguri by indigenous engineers and directed the Ministry for Higher Education, Science, Technology and Innovation to capture their needs in the 2022 budget with an assurance to support their overseas training to widen their horizon. Governor Zulum, during the month of December, again reassured of his administration's determination to improve the socio-economic and infrastructural development of the state, stressing that if not for the insurgency, more than double the number of projects executed would have been delivered. The governor said this while on assessment tour to Customs Muna 10-kilometer dual carriageway, flyover construction and concrete side drainage, including street lights and additional beautification lights. Also in the month of December, Governor Babagana Umarazulum was in Damaturu, Yobe State, and chaired the sixth edition of the Northeast Governors Forum meeting, where he called on the military to intensify operations to free the zone of terrorists. Professor Zulum emphasized that if the Boko Haram terrorism is not brought to an end, there will be impediments to the overall growth and development of all the six states in the Northeast.
How best to address such challenges? In our collective desire to generally improve the quality of life of our people and the infrastructure deficit of the sub-region. Equally worrisome is the socio-economic scourge affecting the sub-region, brought about youth restlessness, massive unemployment. I want to use this opportunity to call on the Nigerian military, paramilitary and others to ensure that they reach into the enclaves of the insurgency. We must pursue them because the nexus between peace, security and development need not to be overemphasized. And therefore, we shall do everything possible to ensure that this insurgency is brought to an end.
Governor Babagana Umara showered encomiums on the security for their commitment to protecting lives and property and described the recent developments in the fight against terrorism as a clear sign of ending insurgency in the region and stressed the need to take the fight to the enclaves of the terrorists and neutralize them.
We, the governors of the Northeast sub-region, are committed to creating an enabling environment for the common man, men and women, to cultivate their lands. To this effect, our North State Command, in collaboration with the Nigerian military, have completely reopened fishing activities in Baga. Under no circumstances, we, the governors of the region, will be silent in such a way that the region should be taken over by the terrorists. We must say the fact, we must say the truth to anybody, and we shall do the right thing.
Also in the month of December, Governor Babagana Umara Zulum was a guest and represented President Muhammadu Buhari at the 63rd independence anniversary of Niger Republic held at Difa province. Prior to representing the president at the Independence Day of neighboring Niger Republic, Professor Zulum had distributed irrigation parks to 2,000 resettled farmers in Damasa, headquarters of Mobar local government, which shares border with Difa province. Governor Babagana Umara directed for the construction of 500 tube well boreholes to increase access to water for irrigation activities, in addition to parks, each consisting of water pump with accessories, NPK fertilizer, non-selective herbicides, fuel, engine oil, and rice seedlings. Governor Zulum also inspected a massive water project being constructed by Senator Abubakar Kiari as part of his constituency interventions in Damasak, where he commended the senator for the laudable project. Also during the month under review, Governor Babagana Umara Zulum approved 1 month salary bonus for thousands of civilian Joint Task Force CJTF hunters, sanitation staff, as well as cleaners working in government establishments, agencies and parastatals as end of the year gift. Similarly, in December, Governor Babagana Umara Zulum clarified the state government's position on the banning of the distribution of food and non-food items to resettled communities by non-governmental organizations operating in the state. Governor Zulum re-echoed his appreciation to the NGOs for their humanitarian and developmental interventions to the state, stressing that any partner willing to support existing IDPs and other communities should seek approval through the Borno State government, as his administration is striving hard to ensure sustainable livelihood for returnees after resettlement.
We remain eternally grateful for your support We look forward to continuing to work with you to support our people to not only survive, but live purposeful lives with dignity and respect, which is central to being humans. International humanitarian partners, CSOs, and the federal government rapidly mobilized and supported the Borno State government and provided the needed aid necessary for people to survive and have shelters over their heads. Camps were created as temporary housing to alleviate the acute humanitarian crisis. Our people living in IDP camps are tired, and many decided that they wanted to go back to their communities. For example, people from Gandhi decided to move by themselves. People from Damaso moved from the camps in Niger by themselves. And we were only told after the fact. We, however, have an obligation to go to anywhere that we are judged as secure and where our people live. Decision is community-driven approach decision. We have been receiving tremendous requests from those that are living in the internally displaced persons that they are willing to go back home. But we resisted all attempts to return them because of the fluid security situation in some of the areas. Now that we started witnessing gradual return of peace to Borno State, we decided to return support those IDPs that are willing to go back to their original homes with some sort of support.
He said the return of the IDPs to their ancestral homes is a citizen-driven demand and is in line with the Kampala Convention, with adequate arrangement to support them through small and medium enterprises, in addition to the provision of food items and cash support that will sustain them as government is determined to build resilience among the returnees. Professor Umara Zulum implored the humanitarian partners to fish out fake NGOs operating in the state, as his administration is doing everything possible to streamline the activities of partners in the state, saying the people will not remain dependent for the rest of their lives. Also in the month of December, Governor Babagana Umara Zulum received President Muhammadu Buhari, who was on invitational visit to commission milestone projects executed by the governor. Governor Zulum, in company of President Muhammadu Buhari, were in Kushari and commissioned the Tijani Bolori Memorial Day Secondary School, a mega school constructed by the Borno State government to address the problem of out-of-school children.
Your Excellency, as you have rightly pointed out, this is one of the many schools that we have built in order to address the challenging problem of out-of-school children. This school is named after our dead elder statesman, Olaji Tijani Bolori, who died recently. In addition to this one, Your Excellency, the road that we have just followed, the government of Borno State deemed it necessary. And we have named it after our elder statesman, Raji Muhammad Ibrahim, because his house is on the main road. So as from today, we decided to call this Dambua Road, call it Raji Muhammad Ibrahim Road. With this remark, I want to invite you, Your Excellency, to commission this project.
I mean.
At the Shehu of Borno's palace, Governor of Zulum and the Shehu of Borno appreciated President Muhammadu Buhari for providing security to the state, which made it possible for farmers to partake in agricultural activities this farming season.
Your Excellency, I want to once again appreciate you for all the projects that you have initiated in Borno State. During your last coming to Borno State, you did promise to the people of Borno State for the establishment of 50 megawatt thermal power plant. I'm pleased to notify you that the NNPC has started the construction of the 50 megawatt power plant. We are so grateful. Again, when you came in, you gave a marching orders to the Nigerian Army to ensure that they created access for our teaming farmers to farm. Your Excellency, I wish to inform you that this year, you cannot imagine the extent of which people of Borno State have farmed. These are a few of the instances that you have given us the opportunity and we have seen the approval on ground. May Almighty Allah give you the wisdom, courage and fortitude to continue with the good works that you are doing. We remain eternally grateful to you, Your Excellency, sir.
I, on behalf of myself, the Borno State Council of Chiefs and the good people of Borno, welcome Your Excellency for yet another official engagement in our state. It is gratifying to inform Your Excellency that peace is gradually returning to Borno, and we must sincerely appreciate and commend your administration for the effort so far made toward bringing lasting peace to Borno and the Northeast sub-region. Permit me at this juncture to commend the zeal, commitment, and dedication of the officers and men of the Nigerian Armed Forces who have brought reasonable peace to Borno. We also extend our sincere condolence to those who paid the supreme prices in the course of duty. In prayers for their success and peace to prevail in all parts of the country, and indeed for Mr. President, who, despite all odds, have made tremendous success in the rapid development in all sectors of Nigerian economy. Your Excellency, I need not to say much on our amicable governor, His Excellency Professor Babagana Umar Azulu, who, in spite of the security challenges confronting this state, is always tremendously making effort to restore Borno, lost glory as home of peace, as well as embarking on projects that have positive impact on life of our community.
President Muhammadu Buhari also commissioned the multi-billion naira 3.55 kilometer combined flyover at the customs area and a 10 kilometer dual carriageway along the Maiduguri Muna Road. Governor Umar Azulum appreciated the president for honoring the invitation, support to the government and the people of Borno.
I commissioned this flyover and 10 kilometers to align the road and the government of Borno State to the glory of Borno.
Kishin kai eh gwamna ne gwamnan kukuru pesa ne.
In my car, oh my vehicle while we are driving in here, I congratulated the governor for putting this infrastructure, whether deliberately or not, he is permanently putting his name in the historical development of infrastructure of Borno State. Because these are the type of things that cannot be hidden or ignored. I congratulate him for doing all these things for the short time he is in the government.
Governor Babagana Umara, in company of President Muhammadu Buhari, also commissioned the Center for Distance Learning, an international conference center built and donated to the University of Maiduguri by Alhaji Muhammadu Indimi.
Thank you.
Governor Zulum rounded off his engagements for December with President Buhari addressing troops at the Air Force wing of the Maiduguri International Airport.
I urge you to continue to cooperate with other security agencies with a view to ensuring a full return to normalcy. Our administration will continue to work with all well-meaning stakeholders, including friendly nations, civil society organizations, as well as credible non-governmental organizations, to bring peace to all troubled areas across the nation. Let me express our deep appreciation to the government of Borno State for its continuous cooperation with the federal government in multiple spheres. This has been critical to the furtherance of our mutual efforts at restoring peace in the state. I particularly commend His Excellency Babagana Umar Zulum for his untiring commitment and cherished collaboration with the administration for the overall good of the people of Borno.